everyone, welcome back to Sweetie Pie Pets. Today we are going to talk about why I no longer take my Chihuahuas to dog parks. Dog parks, you see them everywhere. They come with double gates, dog waste stations, fire hydrants. You see water features and like natural ponds. And some even have agility playgrounds. How cool! And there are even some indoor dog parks in like cold locations.
Sounds like fun, right?
By the end of this video, I will tell you all the reasons why I no longer take my Chihuahuas to these fun sounding dog parks. Please like, comment, and subscribe to Sweetie Pie Pets. Click the bell for alerts when I release a new video. And don't forget to stay tuned all the way to the end of this video to hear my pick for the comment of the week. So dog parks have been around since the late 70s when a group in Berkeley, California started an experiment. They named this experiment Ohlone Dog Park. So the concept of this experiment was simple. With all the laws with dogs having to be on leashes when they're out in public places, people feel a little bit confined because they want a place where they can take their dogs, that the dogs can interact and roam free, which I totally understand. And so this trend started to spread. By some estimates, there are now over 1,000 dog parks here in the United States, with Boise, Idaho, and Portland, Oregon having the most dog parks per capita.
Sounds great. So what's the problem?
Well, let's just get right into my list of three things why I don't think it's such a great idea to take my Chihuahua to dog parks. So this list might not apply to all of you, and some of you guys might not agree with my list. So please put your comment down below if you have additional reasons why you don't think it's a good idea to take your dogs to the dog park, or if you totally disagree with my reasons. I'd love to hear either way. So the number one reason is simply exposure to disease. There is definitely a risk allowing your little sweetie pie to run around in areas that have a high concentration of where other dogs have been because they may have left something lovely behind. So parvovirus is a very, very deadly dog disease that you don't want your dog to get. And unfortunately, it's not spread necessarily from dog to dog contact, because the virus itself can live in the dirt for up to a year or more. So if an infected dog goes to a dog park and then it poops, that virus will sit there for at least a year. And your dog might come along and smell that poop and unfortunately be exposed to parvovirus. Just because your dog has been vaccinated doesn't necessarily prevent them from coming down with the disease. It's still a risk to be exposed to it. And besides parvo, there are other diseases that your dog can catch from being in an environment where other sick dogs were. And by the way, let me mention one thing. Most of these viruses have an incubation period where the dog isn't even necessarily presenting any symptoms. You could have a sick dog that you don't realize is sick and you take it to the park and then it poops and leaves behind whatever germs it leaves and you don't even realize for a couple days that it's sick. And meanwhile, you just exposed every other dog that comes to visit that dog park. And that's why I usually carry my Chihuahua whenever we go out in public. I know there's a lot of viewers who don't like it when you carry your Chihuahua, because after all, they are a dog and they have feet and they can walk. And I get that, but with my little Chihuahua, I just want to keep him safe. Even if I'm going to a veterinarian, especially if I'm going to a veterinarian, that's where a lot of diseases are. Any area that has a high concentration of other dogs and other dog owners is a very likely great place to be exposed to some disease. So I know that might sound kind of paranoid, but the truth is I just don't trust a lot of other people to fully vaccinate their dogs, which I will never understand. My number two reason for no longer taking my Chihuahua to the dog park is that other dogs can sometimes become unruly. So dogs, even when they're just kind of playing, sometimes their play fight can turn a little bit aggressive if one of them is trying to, you know, size up the other one. With my Chihuahua being the smallest dog breed, they just don't stand a chance against a larger dog if a larger dog did decide to chomp. And I'm not saying they would, but it's just not worth the risk to me. And in some cases, it might not be such a big problem if the big dog owners would like maybe pay a little more attention. But I think sometimes at dog parks, people just sort of use it as an excuse to let their dog run wild while they don't necessarily pay attention. And they might not notice if their dog is about to turn and become aggressive. Reason number three is that dog parks aren't necessarily the cleanest places. A lot of dogs go into the park and they're running and playing and then their bowel gets moving and then they end up relieving themselves. And so you're often gonna find the evidence of that. Even though there's cleanup stations, some people are not that great at following through with that, which I also will never understand. And some of these dogs are so big that their poop is like the size of my dog. Now, most owners are pretty good about using the waste station, but not all of them. You will probably find some poop if you go to the dog park.
Isn't it funny, looking over my list, I see the problem actually lies with humans who don't clean up after the dog or pay attention or vaccinate their dog?
None of these reasons are really the dog's fault. They're actually the owner's fault. So there are other reasons as well, such as like unruly kids maybe trying to interact with my dog, or somebody maybe not latching the double gate correctly. But again, those are sort of human issues and not so much the dog. So it's for these three reasons that I don't take my Chihuahua to the dog park anymore. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. The comment of the week comes from the most random channel ever. I kind of want a Chihuahua because of how small they are, but I also want a pit bull.
Ooh.
But the problem with Chihuahua is they can easily get attacked by a bigger dog. That's what we just talked about. I have a Chihuahua mix and he got attacked by a big dog many times. I can't decide, a pit bull or a Chihuahua, what do you think? By the way, I sort of paraphrased that. I definitely think you need a Chihuahua, of course. Chihuahuas are the perfect breed, and if you didn't know that already, you can watch my video here on the 13 reasons why I think Chihuahuas make the perfect pet. I will see you guys next time on Sweetie Pie Pets. Bye.